I'm Subhash Shankar, and in this session, we will cover the most interesting feature of VMware Cloud Provider Hub, where from a single console, a provider can get the aggregated usage and the aggregated effective usage for any organization. A provider can generate and view usage in a provider organization for the provider org as well as any of the tenant orgs underneath this provider for the period selected. By default, it provides the usage for the last billing period. However, you can select up to 6 months. The usage will be available up to last 6 months. Let us view the usage for a tenant organization convo for the period of January, where the service VMware Cloud on AWS has been activated. We can see that the usage for this tenant organization is the aggregated usage for the SKU, that is the host being deployed, is 2016.208, and the effective usage is 1344. Let us view the usage for a tenant organization convo for the period of January, where the service VMware Cloud on AWS has been activated. We can see that the usage for this tenant organization is the aggregated usage for the SKU, that is the host being deployed, is 2016.208, and the effective usage is 1344. In order to understand the aggregated usage and the aggregated effective usage for the SKU for VMware Cloud on AWS, let's log into the service in Convo. Let's open the service VMware Cloud on AWS, and we can see that the SDDC is deployed with three hosts. So three hosts are on demand for the month of January. And also we see that there is a reserved subscription for one host in the same region. Let us see how the aggregate usage and the aggregate effective usage for this queue was calculated. Let's download the file, CSV file. And if we open the CSV file, we find that there is an entry for every hour that the SDDC has been running. So when the SDDC was deployed, the usage starts. So this SDDC has been deployed or has been running on the 1st of January of 2019. So there were three hosts deployed, which is the usage quantity for this queue. And there was a one-year term reservation for one host in the same region. So that appears as the commit quantity. And the billable quantity is the usage quantity minus the commit quantity, which is aggregated usage quantity, that is the total of this queue for this whole month is calculated. And that appears as the aggregate usage against this queue. The total of the effective usage, that is the billable quantity, the total of the billable quantity appears as the total effective usage, which is 1344. If we did not have a reserved subscription, then the effective usage and the total usage, the total effective usage and the total usage would exactly be same, which is 2016.2074. Though the only service available is VMware Cloud on AWS, we also found a SKU for VMware Log Intelligence. Now, the reason for that is Log Intelligence Audit Log Collection feature is now a core service to VMware Cloud on AWS customers. So if you have VMware Cloud on AWS service, you can access VMware Log Intelligence under My Services, and the audit logs are available for VMware Cloud on AWS customers. So here, if we go to the dashboard, we see that the SDDC that was deployed, the audit logs for that SDDC are, the logs are being monitored here. If VMware Log Intelligence is a core feature to VMware Cloud on AWS, what is the reason for VMware Log Intelligence usage to be appearing here? So only the audit logs for VMware Cloud on AWS is offered free. However, the service itself is offered on a trial for 30 days And after 30 days, it can be upgraded to a paid tier, which is what here the service provider has upgraded VMware Log Intelligence to a paid tier for non-audit log collections too. And that usage is tracked monthly. And if there is a long-term subscription, just like in VMware Cloud on AWS, the effective usage would also be calculated. Thanks for watching. For any latest updates on the pricing and the feature support for services, you should visit the service website.